I will be in the NBA. One day, I will be in the NBA. And the coolest part of this story is that my mom and dad looked at me and they said, you know what? If anyone can do it, you can. Now, I don't know about you guys, and I don't know, like I said, NBA championships are going on. There is something that's different from me and them. You'll figure it out later. No need to have an open book quiz or test, any of that. But the fact that I had my parents who believed in me and believed in my goal and told me that anything that I did was possible. Every single day, that's what I focus on. You see, when my mom and dad told me that and I grabbed my paperback, I went back upstairs and I taped that paper on my mirror. Because the first thing that we always do every single day that we wake up is go to the bathroom. I hope. Brush teeth, take a shower, yeah, you know. Every day, I looked at that goal. And every single day when I left that house, I realized in order for me to reach my goal, I had to do all the little things to get me to that. Focus on your goal. The second thing that I think about is just positivity. The first time I saw Pat Summitt, I was 8th grade, and I was sitting on my couch, complaining to my mom, there's nothing to watch on TV. Anybody else done that? No. And I'm flipping and I'm flipping, and all of a sudden, all I saw were eyes. Kind of freaked me out, but I was intrigued too. And as the camera panned out, all I saw was orange. Amazing. And then I saw this crazy lady stomping up and down on the sideline, and I'm like, whoa, who is she? What is this? What's going on? 8th grade, Pat Summitt. Late volunteer, blown away. And I said, if I could ever do good enough to play for this crazy lady, I think I would like that. Sophomore year, first time I got a letter from the University of Tennessee. Junior year, committed to the University of Tennessee. Freshman year, first practice. Y'all want to go to practice with me? First practice. Oh, never forget this. So before we got to practice, all the upperclassmen would tell us, oh, I hope you're in shape. I hope you're ready. Because all we do is run. And so, you know, we came in at the Fab Four, Tamika Brown, Teresa Jeter, Christian H. Clement, and myself. And so we were like, oh, we gotta do extra work. So we run hills, we went to the football stadium, we run the stairs, we're doing all of that. Because now we're freaked out. Well, I'll say this. Until that day, I never really had a coach tell me that I've done anything wrong. So, you know, I came in, maybe a little fool of myself. And we're doing a defensive drill. Two lines, fitting on the basketball court, right? Two lines, offensive line, defensive line. So I get up and I got a dress on, so I can't really give you the full effect because I don't want to, you know, I'm sorry. So I get down to my defensive stand, and all of a sudden, Tamika! I just got to defense. Get your butt down. Get your arm out! Butt down, arm out, okay. I got beat. And I got beat again. And I got beat again. And in my head, I'm like, this lady has no idea how to play defense. I don't know how to play defense. Mind you, they had just won a championship that year before, but that's okay. I know. And so I went to the end of the line, and I'm a little upset. And I get up the second time, and I get my defensive stance. Tamika! Get your butt down. Get your arm out. butt down, arms out. I got beat over and over and over. Now I'm mad because she had no idea how to play defense. Not everybody plays defense like that, like Schmeichel. Not everybody does, or does Schmeichel play defense, but doesn't matter. Not everybody plays like that. And I'm mad. So when I get back to the front, Pat is in the corner, way over there, like where they are, back to the court, not even paying attention. I get up and play my defense, and all of a sudden I hear, "Tamika! What?" And the gym went quiet. Just like that. Because we always had open practice, and we always had fans that were sitting there because they wanted to see what the freshmen were like. And it took me a second. Did I say that? Or did I think that? And in that moment when I'm looking and you use your peripheral because you don't want to lose focus, and everybody's like, and all she said, "Get your butt down, get your arm out." Butt down, arms out. And I got through that drill and she called me underneath the basket and, you know, past her stance. She always had a leg up. And she's looking at me. Not really looking at her, it's kind of scary that way. Okay. Am I gonna have to handle you with lace gloves? That was her way of saying, like a girl. She couldn't stand when people said, "Oh, you play like a girl. You do this like a girl." Am I gonna have to handle you with lace gloves? No, ma'am. No. Am I gonna have to send you back to Duncanville, Texas? Just like that, and I was like, let's think about this. If I go home, my mom's gonna kill me. If I stay here, you're gonna kill me, but whatever. So I chose to stay. Needless to say, that was the last time that her and I had a run-in like that. When I think about positive people being in my circle and positive people being in our circle, think about the coaches, the teachers, the athletic directors, the newspapers, all these sponsors that are here, all the people that are here that want to see you do positive things. My dad used to tell me when I was in school, "Now, Tamika, you pick your friend, don't let your friend pick you." And I was like, "Dad, that is the silliest thing I've ever heard in my life." But one thing I started realizing as I got better and better in sports is that when I had a good game, I had a whole entourage of people around me. But when I had a bad game or I made a bad performance, my entourage became slimmer and slimmer. And then I had another good game and I had a big entourage. And it took me a while to realize that all these people that were in my entourage weren't really there for me. And so every single level that I made it to, the entourage would fluctuate until I realized, you know what? I want people around me that want to be around me for who I am, not for what I do. So when we think about positivity, while this might sound silly, make sure that you guys pick the people that you want in your circle. Because if I hung out with the people that wanted to go to the mall every single day, I wouldn't have made it to the level that I made it to. My friends knew my goal. They knew one day I would be in the NBA. And so my friend rebounded for me and passed me the ball and went to the gym because that's where I wanted to be. So number one, focus on the goal. Number two, always surround yourself with positive people. And number three, bring your skills to the table. How many of you guys have some skills? All the athletes are working on it. Y'all got skills or not? Wouldn't be here if you didn't. 2009, we went all the way to the WNBA final, and we lost. 2012, we finally won a championship. But I'm going to talk about 2015. 2015 Indiana Fever, we started to see them. We had some wins and we had some losses. And one day I was walking around my favorite store of all time, is Target. So one day I was walking around and I'm like, I'm the leader of this team. How do I get my teammates on board? So I went to the kids section and I found a puzzle. And my mind just started going crazy. Oh, I got this great idea. So I texted my teammates and said, hey guys, we are going to have a team meeting at 9 o'clock tomorrow before practice. I need everybody to be there by 9 o'clock. So some of my teammates were like, oh, we've been having meetings. I don't want to meet again. And I'm like, oh, no, this is different. This is different than before. And so I went home and I got 12 plastic bags and I put, I divvied out my little puzzle pieces. Got to the locker room at 8 o'clock because I like to be early for everything. On time is late, right? We always learn that. Being on time is late. So I got there at 8 o'clock and I put the puzzle pieces in the chair. And some of my teammates started flowing in. And then all of a sudden, 9 o'clock hits. And I like to start on time too. So I stand up and I'm like, okay. When I was a kid, I used to love doing puzzles. There was something about looking at a picture, finding the pieces inside, and knowing that those pieces would look like the picture at the end. We're gonna do a puzzle today! And that's when you guys said, yay! No, too late. So 8 players get down, 4 players stay in a chair because they're too cool to do this puzzle. So we get the puzzle going. And what do you think happened? We can't finish the puzzle. So now all of a sudden, one of the other 8, or one of the other 7, turned to the other 4 in the chair and was like, yo, like, you guys need to get down here. We can't finish this puzzle without you. So they eventually got down and we finished the puzzle. And they're like, okay, that's great, now what? And what I did, I stood up and I took one of the pieces. And I said, when we came in here, each of you had between 3 to 4 pieces in your chair, in your body. Each one of those pieces represents something that you bring to this team. You might be a good passer, you might be a good screener, you might be a good shooter, you might be a good leader, you might be a good communicator, all the different skills that go into basketball. Well, for my pieces, I'm a good leader, I'm a good communicator, I'm a good shooter. I think I'm a pretty good teammate. But what if I came to practice one day and I said, today, I just don't feel like being here. I don't want to talk to you guys, and so I don't talk. And I know you guys need me to score, but you know what? I don't feel like scoring today, and I don't score. But what if you're a good screener and you say, you know what? I'm tired of screening for you all the time to get open. When am I going to get my shot? And you don't screen. And then you pass the ball all the time, but nobody passes to you. So I'm not passing. I'm shooting every time I get it, even if I can't shoot. And if every single person on the team has that mentality, what kind of team do you have? So when we bring our skills to the table, it's about figuring out what it is that you're good at. And this isn't just for the athlete, this is for all of us. For whatever work we do. If you don't bring your skill every single day, and every single thing that you do, you let down every single person that's in your circle. So every day, when you wake up, every single thing you do, you gotta aim for perfection. Or aim high, maybe not perfection, that might be a little stretchy. So one, focus on a goal. 2, positive, have positive people around you. 3, bring your skill to the table. And the 4th thing, don't let adversity stop you. I tore my ACL my senior year at the University of Tennessee. Playing against Mississippi State, I think there's 2 minutes left in the second quarter. Did an in and out, half court, come down, got a wide open layup, go up. Everything comes crashing down. Well, I told you, 7th grade, I made the goal I wanted to be in the NBA. when I got to tell you, freshman year in college, the WNBA started, and they made a league, especially for me. And then senior year, I go down. So this is a real question. How many of you guys, if something gets broken at your house, you go to the store and you get a broken piece to fix another broken piece? Anybody in here? Well, that's what I thought. Who's gonna take a chance and drafting a player with a torn ACL that can't play? Why would you do that? Well, thank God you pushed through, and thank God Indiana took a chance. And I got drafted to Indiana Fever in 2001 draft, the third pick overall, with a torn ACL. Since then, tore my ACL that first year, tore my plantar fascia, partially tore the other one, tore my Achilles, broke a couple fingers, broke my nose a couple times, but guess what? We still here! I hate to say this, but we're all gonna face adversity. The choice we have is how we're gonna handle it and how we're gonna bounce back. I don't brag on myself when I say this, but tore my ACL my senior year, got drafted, came back, got rookie of the year. Tore my Achilles in 2007, but I wanted to be on the Olympic team so bad in 2008 that you push through, you do what you gotta do, and you make the team, and you win a gold medal. Adversity hits. What are you gonna do to get through? Hang your head down, give up, not push, woe is me. You can't do that. Because in every step that you go, in every single thing you do, it keeps coming. And that's how you build your character. And then the last thing, the fifth thing, enjoy the ride. Enjoy the process. If you would have told me, or told that little girl at 3 years old, that she would have had all of the success that she had, nobody would have believed it. I didn't believe it. But through every single phase in life and every single thing that I've learned, I've enjoyed the process. It's almost like when you drive a car. How many of you guys drive comfort? Anybody? Right? You know? Are you sure? No, we drive like this. Because we gotta be cool with it. You can't enjoy the process when you're trying to determine every single step and every single move. You can't enjoy the process. But you know when you lean back in the driving, the wheel moves by itself sometimes. And then you just catch it and you might guide it. That's how we enjoy the process. Focus on a goal. Surround yourself with positive people. Bring all your skill to the table. Don't let adversity stop you. And enjoy the process. So we're gonna do this one more time. On the count of three, we're gonna stand up if we wanna be a champion. And I'm gonna drop the mic. One, two, three. And now we're gonna say, I wanna be a champion, and then I want y'all to get super loud because I know we still have the second half. We got a lot of athletes that we wanna recognize. You got it? On the count of three, I wanna be a champion. Then you're gonna, woo! Whatever you want to do. One, two, three.
One, two, three.
Time out, time out. I told y'all at the beginning I do lips. So I see a lot of people just smiling, and I like smiles too. But let's participate, okay? Participation is necessary. 1, 2, 3, I want to be a champion. I want them clapping, I want them screaming, I want all that. And then I'll get off the stage. Ready? 1, 2, 3!